Hi to the K&J fam, and you're rocking with Kristen and Jamia, and we're back, you guys, for another mukbang!
What?
But not just any mukbang!
Yes!
You guys, today we're doing a Battle of the Wings mukbang. We have Wingstop versus Wingman, which is a local chicken
star.
Wing place.
Yeah.
Local five-star review restaurant in our city. Mm-hmm. So Wingman and Wingstop. So we're going to see which one is better.
Exactly.
While we're indulging.
That's right. We also got a few other things from Wingstop because we felt like it.
The corn.
So we got Cajun corn. We got some fries. What is it? Voodoo fries.
Yep.
So we're about to get it in, hook it up. So this is the way it's going to work. These are our favorite wings from Wingstop. And these were what we thought would be our favorite Wingman wings. So we're going to try it. We're going to see which one tastes better.
Yeah, we'll see if Wingman lives up to his 5-star review.
Exactly. The different sauces, but you know. Okay. Yeah. What are we doing?
Let's thumbnail.
Thumbnail?
Let's get it in. Okay.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
How am I thumbnailing? This is, I got
to
be different.
I wanted to say poorly. I'm nailing poorly.
I got an idea.
Okay.
The fries. 1, 2, 3.
You see my look I gave you?
I can't get this right.
I know.
One more time.
I'm well aware.
One, two, three.
Okay. Yep, you lost it.
I lost it.
And we both, honestly, that first video we did, we killed it.
I know.
We did a great thumbnail. It was only one pose.
One take.
Ever since. It's taken 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm. Well, you know I blame you, right?
Do you blame me? You can blame me. Because I blame you. We have ranch dressing in the back here, you guys.
Yes, plenty of it.
Mm.
We got like 5 containers back here. 6 containers.
Mm-hmm.
We don't play with ranch. We do not play, you guys. Okay. Which wing did you have?
I had garlic parmesan.
Okay.
From Wingstop.
Okay, cool. All right, I'm going to try this. So this right here is a honey mustard one from Wingman.
Mm-hmm.
The ones on the front are like a barbecue sauce, but they're different. They're a little more tangy. But I want to try this by itself first, and I'm going to try my favorite, which are the Hawaiian ones. Sorry about that.
Are you going by yourself? Or are we doing this
solo,
or are we doing it together?
You know what? You took the first bite. I thought we were going...
I thought we were going in two. And then I realized we're reviewing both. My bad.
All right. You ready?
So honey mustard of Wingman.
Yes,
local place.
Exactly.
Okay.
Here we go. Let's try it.
I don't love the honey mustard.
Okay.
I'm going to give this rest to you if you want it.
Oh, you put it right there.
So it doesn't go to waste.
Okay.
It's hard because I feel like the honey mustard is not my favorite.
Mm.
Looks like you enjoyed it, though.
I did. I like honey mustard.
Mm-hmm.
I'd rather enjoy it.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I'd rather enjoy it.
So I'm going to have another bite of the garlic parmesan from Wingstop.
Okay.
Just to officially confirm.
Yeah.
That I enjoy Wingstop right now.
Okay, cool. And let's try one of these other ones. Let's try the barbecue ones.
Okay.
You got it?
Mm-hmm.
All right, cool. Now, the barbecue one, I'm not 100% sure exactly what they put in there. It's kind of like a, I don't know, it wasn't a sweet barbecue. It's more of like a...
Tangy?
Tangy one, I think. Be the way I put it. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm. I enjoy this barbecue. Okay.
It's pretty good. But it ain't...
I like a sweet barbecue, though.
You do like it? It is kind of sweet, I guess.
Okay. It is.
I was thinking it wasn't going to be sweet.
I don't know what happened. I tried to pull this apart, and I got it all over me. Mm-hmm. What do you think?
Well, I do like this better than the honey mustard one.
Mm-hmm.
I do like the honey mustard one.
Mm-hmm.
But...
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if I like it better than Wingstop.
Mm-hmm.
I'm about to try one of these Hawaiian barbecue ones.
From Wingstop.
From Wingstop.
Mm-hmm.
And know what's up. Let's see.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm. You know what?
Huh.
You like this one better?
Stop for me. Mm-hmm.
I'm going to be honest. I think the Wingman flavor is a little bit better.
Of the this barbecue?
One, yeah, the barbecue one, yeah.
Mm.
This one, I mean, maybe it could be there's not as much sauce as there was on the... So the Wingman one has a little more sauce than the Wingstop one. But I feel like the flavor just tastes a little bit better on the Wingman one.
Mm-hmm.
I like it.
I disagree.
I like it. I think it's good. Huh?
I disagree.
With me?
Yeah.
Kristen, you can never disagree with me. That's cool. You can prefer it, huh?
Mm-hmm. Mm.
I get it. You know what? I see how it is.
Mm.
Either way, I'm happy with them. I'm super happy.
I think the Wingstop, well, for one, they're bigger.
They are. They are a lot bigger. That's very true.
Juicier.
Well, yeah, I mean, to an extent.
Yeah.
I feel you, though. I feel you.
Mm. So,
Listen, I get it with the honey mustard one.
Mm-hmm.
I do get that.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're a little biased to Wingstop.
Mm. I don't think I would be, though.
You didn't think so?
Mm-mm.
I knew you would.
You think so?
Yes, because I know you. Because I know anytime it's something new, you're kind of questioning it.
Do I do that?
Yeah, you do.
And call me out?
I'll call you out. Mm. So ultimately, I love this place. I think that place was really good. I think their wings for sure, I mean, overall, there's not as many flavors, of course, as Wingstop. But it's still good. It's up there.
I wouldn't call their wings 5 stars.
I wouldn't call it 5 stars either.
That's for sure. Mm-hmm.
I wouldn't call them 5 stars, but...
But they're okay for like a local joint.
Yeah, for a local, definitely for a local place, they're
mm-hmm.
really good.
Mm-hmm.
The quality. But, yeah, I don't know. In a minute, guys, too, we're going to play a game. We're going to do... What's it called? What game is it?
How well do we know each other?
How well do we know each other? That's right. We just mm-hmm. have some questions that we're going to ask each other. See how well we know each other.
Mm-hmm.
Mm.
You think you're going to know me better?
I do know you better.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like you don't know me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
The fact that you don't understand that I'm a 4.0 GPA student.
You surprised us all.
Yeah, exactly.
The other day.
During the live, you guys, I was probably the best person ever playing.
Okay.
During a
trivia. This is why he can't do well, because it gets to his head.
You don't understand. I don't need to get to my head. I know what I can do. When I play trivia, guys, sometimes, occasionally, I'll get the wrong answers.
Oh, my gosh.
But the other night, I couldn't miss.
Occasionally, like every other time.
There was nothing I couldn't answer.
Yeah, no.
There was nothing I couldn't answer. Did I get everything right?
Mm. Mostly.
I don't think I missed any.
Let's calm down.
I'm just stating facts. Do you want me to state the facts? I'm stating the facts, you guys.
You're so proud of yourself.
Did I not kill it?
You did.
Was that not amazing?
You guessed.
Kristen, that's not the question. Did I not kill it? Was I not amazing?
Let's call a spade a spade.
Let's say, okay, here's the question. Was I amazing?
I mean, you did really well. You did very well.
Not amazing? Give him my track record. Was it amazing?
You have to define amazing.
Give him my track record. Was it amazing?
Compared to how you normally do, it really was.
So then I was amazing?
No, you're so annoying.
I just want clarity.
Yeah, I'm sure you do.
I just want clarity.
It was impressive.
Cool.
It was impressive.
Have you ever had a night like that?
Yes! Every night. God. Every other night. I have had a night like that, okay?
Of course you're going to say that.
Yeah, no, well, it's facts.
I was saying the same thing.
Yeah, I have had a night like that, okay? Yeah.
Yeah.
Come join me on my level.
Well, it wasn't Sunday night. Okay. Anyway.
No, you're on a roll.
Killed it.
Mm-hmm.
A roll would be simple. I was killing it.
Gosh.
Even a lot of the fam was, they realized, they saw it.
Fam.
A lot of the fam were like, whoa, Janelle. Please smack him. This is crazy.
Smack him for me.
Nah, I'm teasing, obviously. For all of you that think I'm think I'm serious, I'm joking. 100%. Luck wasn't the word. No,
luck serious. Wasn't the word.
Luck wasn't the word. Miracle is better.
That was funny.
Cool. So what do you think? You happy?
I'm a fan.
Every time we do Wingstop, Kristen's very hangry.
I love Chunky. And I don't want to talk, usually.
Yeah, what's up with that?
I don't know.
Listen. This is a talking mukbang channel, Kristen. I'm just teasing.
These are just so good.
They are.
Mm-hmm.
Don't worry, I'll talk for you. So how you doing today?
Okay.
Good.
I'll talk.
What do you prefer out of the two? The Wingstop ones.
You know, they're both really good. The garlic parmesan and the Hawaiian.
Mm-hmm.
I think it depends what kind of mood I'm in, to be honest. Mm-hmm. You know, if you're sometimes in a sweeter mood, sometimes in a more savory.
Yeah.
But today,
mm-hmm.
probably the Hawaiian.
Hawaiian today, huh?
Is winning, yeah. How about you?
Honestly, today I think the garlic is for me.
Yeah.
Normally that's not the case.
Yeah, it isn't the case for you. But, oh, so good, you guys.
I think it's mainly because the Hawaiian's not...
Hitting?
Done. Yeah, it's not.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I feel like maybe there's not as much. Still good, though.
Mm-hmm. I did think that the Hawaiian looked a little bit more plain than it mm-hmm. normally does, so...
Yeah.
That could be why.
It's good, though. I like it. I'm not mad at it. So you guys, this Sunday, if you have not heard already, we're doing a contest,
mm-hmm.
giving away $800 in prizes.
Mm-hmm.
If you're, excuse me, if you're not familiar with it already, you can sign up for our email list where you'll get a little more info.
Mm-hmm.
Or better yet, actually, better yet, check out our, you know what? By this time, you guys will see post either on YouTube on our community page or on Facebook that gives the instructions on how to play. We're just doing trivia.
Rules of the contest.
Yeah, rules of the contest. Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's going to be really fun, you guys.
Yeah.
We're going to do a big giveaway.
Mm-hmm.
It's time. It's overdue for another one. It was in honor of our one-year celebration on this channel, too. So.
Absolutely.
Mm-hmm. So, look at our community post. And you'll see the rules for that.
That's right. And it's going to be fun, you guys. Mm-hmm. If you're down to do it, try it out. We wanted to do something a little different this time that gave everyone kind of an opportunity, a chance to win, rather than kind of doing just a random one by itself. Although, there will be a random drawing. This league gives a little bit more, you know, possibility.
But you said it's on our Facebook page, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Kristen and Jamil is our Facebook page.
Yep. Check it out.
Mm.
Check it out.
Mm.
Okay.
Mm. Mm. I'm so happy.
Is that good?
Mm-hmm. It's delicious. Mm-hmm. Okay, we got some questions now.
Can I ask you?
Mm-hmm.
No way you can eat?
Mm. Do you know what to ask? Because I have the list.
Oh, I was going to grab it.
Yeah. Listen.
Okay. No, that way you can eat.
Look,
I'm looking out for you.
I'm okay.
You sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. Here we go. I mean, I'll still eat, but...
Yeah. Okay. So here goes some questions.
Woo!
The question is, how well do I know Kristen, and how well does she know me? Pretty sure I know Kristen better than she knows me.
Woo!
Pretty confident.
You think so?
Yeah. Pretty confident.
I know you way better. Okay. Here we go.
Uh-huh. Okay.
Okay.
No.
Did I get an allowance as a child?
No. Oh! No.
Okay. Should I answer and then I'll answer for you?
I know the answer. It's no. Okay. You work for free. Okay. Chores for free.
You're right. I did not get an allowance as a child.
Yeah, I wasn't sure.
I did not get an allowance as a child.
You didn't, huh?
No. My dad...
You didn't do it, huh?
Said we're cleaning.
I know.
You're doing this.
Whether you like it a lot or
not. That's what it is, yep.
That's how it was in my household.
Used to keep me inside on weekends.
You're allowed to clean. That's your allowance.
Clean, yeah.
That's your allowance.
I hated cleaning the house. Mm-hmm. It was the worst. But mostly because my dad would just get in a bad mood. Sorry, Dad. Oh. But you did. And you still do. When it's time to clean, he gets in a bad mood.
Well, I do have to say, like, when cleaning, it is serious. You know what I mean? Like, I know when I'm cleaning, yeah, I get focused.
We get focused. It's true.
Focused, and I was like, no joke. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So, you know, it makes sense.
Yeah.
Do you know the answer? Did I answer it?
No. Okay. Let me answer for you.
Okay. Did I get allowances or not?
Hold on.
Uh-oh.
Sorry. Okay.
It's all good.
Heck no, you did not get an allowance.
And I thought Krista knew me. Kristen, I made $1 million as a kid.
Mm-hmm. Your parents, I love your parents. And not I know them very well. They didn't give you guys any money.
Yeah, no, we didn't get any allowances.
For chores, at the least.
We were, once again, allowed to clean. Yeah. That was our allowance.
100%. Uh-huh. What do you think about allowances?
That's a good question.
Now that I think about it.
I don't want at all to make anyone feel bad about my answer. But I feel like, I think it was a good thing that I didn't get allowance. Mm-hmm. Because then I would have felt like, you know, I feel like growing up, I would have maybe felt like, or as I'm getting older, I'd feel like, well, in order for me to do something, I gotta get paid to do it. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I mean, that could be completely wrong. But on the flip side, it's like, well, then, mm-hmm, by growing up thinking I had to do stuff for free.
True. Mm-hmm.
Maybe allowances would have been a good thing.
Yeah. I mean, I just feel in general, now, it's fine if you want to do an allowance. Mm-hmm. Who knows? You know, we might do that one day if we have a kid. But
yeah,
I just feel like you don't necessarily need to, in my opinion, need to reward for everything a child does, you know? And I think what you're saying is, mm-hmm, maybe instilling some, just like, hey, like, this is life. Like, we have to clean, mm-hmm, you know? Mm-hmm. And no, I'm not giving you money for it. Mm-hmm. Kind of, yeah, thing. No, you know, sure. I hear you. Yeah.
I would give my kid for, money for other things. Mm-hmm. Maybe to compensate for allowances.
Okay, I'll keep it real with allowances.
Uh-huh.
If we have a kid and we did do an allowance.
Yeah.
I would only give them the allowance money if they did extra.
Oh.
Does that make sense? Because I had friends that had allowances. They, mm-hmm, did half-ass jobs.
Can I get a napkin over there? Oh, you know what? I got one right
here. What happened to the...
I took it over there.
Oh, you put it back?
I did. Mm-hmm. I didn't think we needed more. Mm-hmm. I'll be back.
Yeah, my friends did really, really shitty jobs. I remember, like, being in... Because, you know, you're over at friends' houses sometimes when they have to do a chore or something. Mm-hmm. Mm-mm. I would not pay for... As a parent... I would not pay for that. That's for sure. So they have to, and I know parents have standards sometimes. Well, anyways, sorry. We shouldn't get into it, but
yeah,
no, my kid has to go like above and beyond if I'm going to give him money for it. Hmm. So I'm not about giving money. I'm just, they have to do really well.
I agree with you on that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Okay.
No, I agree with you.
We could go, I don't want to go in a debate because we could do all this all day. Okay. Mm-hmm. Cool. We both got it right and we grew up the same. Okay, here we go.
Mm-hmm. Let's do it.
Okay. Would I rather... That's kind of bad. I feel shit too. What? Would I rather spend a day with my parents or spend a day with your parents?
Okay. So I feel like this isn't fair.
No?
Well, not really, because... I feel like... Huh?
How's it not fair?
Well, because we're biased to our own parents.
Not everybody.
That's true. Oh, so let's answer the question.
Okay. Then.
You're right.
So would I rather hang out with mine or yours?
100% yours.
Okay.
All right? Did I get it right? Mm-hmm. Had a feeling.
Yes. Mm-hmm. No shade. Would you like to answer my question? No shade on your situation. Mm-hmm. So I don't even want to answer for you because if you don't say my parents, I'm going to get offended. Even though I said mine for me.
Well.
Okay, no, let me think. Hold on.
It's, okay, let me, can I say?
No, can I answer?
Okay, Andrew.
I think you'd probably rather hang out with your mom. But Jermaine's dad passed away, so.
Yeah, my dad passed away. Yeah. But yes, I obviously would rather hang out with my mom.
Yeah.
But it's not this
thing. I hope my mom's watching right now.
Well, here's the thing.
Okay, you just hurt her feelings.
The thing about this question,
it's
a loaded question because
it is.
I grew up with my parents. Yes. I know my mom.
There's a comfort.
I understand, conversation. Doesn't mean that, but see, here's the thing. Mm-hmm. Would I always want to hang out with my parents over your parents? No. Not the case.
Okay.
Not the case at all. You know, I mean, it's just if you're taking an answer specifically literal.
I'll go with ditto on that, too.
Yeah, exactly. You know? Okay. So.
Okay. Cool.
Yeah. Is that cool?
My parents wouldn't, though. I'm just kidding. Okay, here we go.
Mm-hmm.
What was my favorite subject in school?
Your favorite subject in school?
Mm-hmm.
I think you're going to say math. And the thing is, you have to be good at math.
I was good at math. I was so good at math.
Let me think about it. You have to be great at math.
I was excellent.
For math to be.
Math. Okay, let's calm down.
Yes,
math was my favorite subject. You got that right.
Nice. Well, can I say something before you answer mine?
Yes.
You're good at math. I didn't even say anything wrong.
I'm excellent.
And listen, I didn't even go any further.
Go.
You're good at math. However.
No, you can't say however. What are you talking about? I do like calculator in my head.
You do calculator in your head. Listen, here's the thing.
I calculate.
People that are accountants.
I calculate in my head.
Or people that do like, you know, numbers. Just
I'm
numbers.
Not a math mutician.
Those are the people that they're favorite subject in school they can say is math, right? Because that makes sense.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. My favorite subject was math.
Okay. But you're not an accountant.
I would have been. Had I been able to pick many careers.
Really?
Accountant would be one of them.
Yeah, right.
I don't know. Yeah. But I still...
Yeah, nothing else been available.
Okay.
Nothing else in the world. Maybe I would have sent the guy.
I would have done the job that Matt Damon did in Good Will Hunting.
What did he do? Wasn't he a janitor?
He was a genius janitor.
Okay.
Okay, I would have done that job. Okay. No, I don't know. Yeah, math.
Yeah.
Is my dream.
That's your dream. Doing basic math.
Yeah, advanced math. Yeah, maybe that's not for me. Okay, let's calm down.
Okay. I'm giving you a hard time.
Honestly. Yeah, you are. Okay.
How about for me?
Yeah. Well, just admit that I'm a better math person than you are.
No, that's not true.
Okay.
I have a calculator in my head.
Okay.
I can calculate numbers like crazy.
What's 20% of 50?
But see, that's not adding.
Exactly.
On calculator,
exactly.
Original calculators, they didn't have percentages. I have an original calculator.
Do you have an original calculator?
I can add,
so original calculator,
subtract,
original calculator,
multiply, and divide.
They don't do percents.
And there's no percentages, though. No, you're 100% better than me. I am.
Okay.
100%.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Your favorite subject?
Mm-hmm.
If we're going to keep it 100 and you want me to answer this right.
Mm-hmm. I told you what my favorite one was, too. I answered it for you before.
Oh.
Exactly.
I was going to say you didn't have a favorite one because you hated school.
That is true.
Thank you.
But there was a class.
Yeah.
I shouldn't have given you a hint.
No, I know it. I know. You didn't give me a hint.
I gave you a hint.
He said there was a class.
Yes.
Poetry.
Yes.
Listen. We took one semester of poetry.
And I loved it.
In high school.
Yes.
And that was his favorite.
Of course. Well, what else? French? I'm not going to go back there and talk about French and how terrible that was.
We have nowhere to go back to. Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Chemistry.
Oh, chemistry was even worse.
Chemistry looked hard. I didn't take it, but it did look really hard.
Chemistry was way harder than it looked. And it looked extremely hard.
It looked hard.
So it was so hard. It was ridiculous. Okay. Next question.
Mm-hmm.
You want me to do it?
Mm-hmm.
Next question.
Poetry.
Yes, I had a poem called, it was Cinnamon. and it was pretty amazing.
That was the highlight of his career.
Yes, it was all the different ways you could use the word cinnamon.
Who got accepted into the poetry competition in high school?
Me?
Me.
Did you?
Yeah, facts.
What happened to everyone else? They couldn't make it? They canceled after canceled after canceled. They're like, who else we got? Like, okay, let's get Kristen.
I was in the poetry competition. No, it wasn't competition. Yeah. It was just a poetry reading, but I got asked to read.
Yeah.
That was a good one.
Okay. Well, here's a question.
Mm-hmm.
No, we can't say that. Well, the question was, what was your least favorite subject in school?
Okay.
So if you're going to ask me or answer
mine. I know one. Yeah.
What was it?
Least favorite for you?
Yeah. I mean, it's...
Math.
No.
Really?
I mean, see, this isn't fair because I hated everything other than poetry. English, I was okay with.
Okay,
I
chemistry, liked English. You hate him.
I'd probably say chemistry, judging by how terrible I did, where at least in French, I made it to the end to get an F. Like, in chemistry, I dropped out halfway because I was like, I can't answer these questions. I don't know what you're talking about.
No, sorry.
Okay, cool.
What was my least favorite?
Your least favorite is probably, or was probably, English. No, sorry. Let me take that completely back. I said that before I could even think about it.
Okay.
History was your least favorite. Mm-hmm. You hated history.
Mm-hmm. Hate.
You know?
History.
Yes. Mm. Okay.
I don't know why. It's usually people's like favorite.
I know, right?
That's true. Why I suck at it. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. This is fun.
All right.
Oh, this is so good.
It is, huh?
Want this corn?
No, I'm okay for now.
How
were
those fries?
Hmm? Those fries were terrible.
Yeah, I can tell.
They tasted horrible. They were good. You want me to take that?
No, it's cool.
Okay, cool.
Okay, yeah.
I'll take it. Cool, thank you. And, all right, I don't know, I want to...
You got it, babe.
Okay, but see, this is so easy.
But these aren't... Listen, they're easy if we know each other.
Yes, and we know each other pretty well to know this. You know, it's asking questions like, did I go to private or public school? We went to the same school. Am I close to my parents? Yes or no? Let's see, did I...
Honey, let me ask you a question.
No, let me ask one more. Let me ask one more. Come on, some of these are just setups that are messed up. You can never find the good ones. No, listen, there aren't any good ones.
Uh-uh.
Okay, have I ever failed a class? Exactly. Next question.
The whole world knows you're failing the class.
Exactly. Okay. Did I have a favorite teacher? I should probably maybe even say explain a little more.
Mm-hmm.
Have you ever had a teacher that you really loved?
Mm-hmm.
Or have I ever had a teacher that I really loved?
Mm-hmm. Ready?
Yep.
No. There's my answer for you. No.
No, huh?
You did not.
You don't think I did?
Uh-oh.
Well, you'd be wrong.
Really?
Yes. I mean, okay.
Loved. Like, yeah, loved. Like the connection was there.
Yes.
The relationship. You the know. Relationship, you know what I'm talking about, fam.
Yeah.
Who?
Well...
Who?
Let me just say
You're
this.
You're such a liar. You're such a liar. You're such a liar. We're not going to play this game if you're going to lie.
No. I'm dead serious. And you know this answer, by the way. You know this. You just forgot. You forgot this.
Who? Who was it?
Are you ready?
Yes.
It was my fifth grade teacher.
You're looking at me.
You don't remember?
For validation.
My fifth grade teacher gave us all the candy, remember?
Did you have...
Oh, now you remember.
No, I don't.
Remember we played a game? We played a game at the end of the day, and whoever won the game, he would give all of the group the most candy.
Do you remember that? Is this why you're into candy to this day?
Probably. Partially. Do you remember that?
Okay. So a teacher you really liked.
He was the best teacher ever.
Was he?
Was amazing.
Okay.
So this is like my fifth grade teacher.
Mm-hmm.
It was super nice. Always like spoke highly of me, like to the rest of the classroom and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Oh, it was actually fifth grade was like one of my best years. And that's probably why.
Fifth grade was one of my best years too.
It was, right?
Mm-hmm. I had fun.
But anyways, we would play at the end of the day. I didn't tell you about the b-ball game. B-ball? That's what you call it, a b-ball.
Are you lying?
No, I'm serious. Brain ball. It wasn't just basketball. So here's what we did.
Okay.
The whole classroom broke up in groups at the end of the day. This guy was amazing. We broke up in groups at the end of the day. It was like five, maybe six people, depending on the size of the classroom. I can't remember. Mm-hmm. But we broke up in groups. And the way it works is he would ask us trivia questions based off of, it was like a card game where they would, it was like a kid card game where they asked questions like, you know, what's the state capital of this or something like that. And it wasn't necessarily stuff that we knew. It was just questions that were like fifth grade questions. Mm-hmm. And literally, if you answered a question, you'd go to the back of the room and you had a little like ball and you had to toss it all the way to the front of the room in the trash can. Mm. If you did that, you would get like multiple points. So it was a way to get like extra points.
Ooh.
Right? Isn't that fun?
What was his name?
Hella fun. Mr. Hagar.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, exactly.
Good job.
Exactly. And that was a sad time because when I graduated, then I got to sixth grade, which I had potentially some of the worst teachers ever. It was horrible.
That was the downhill of your...
I was in Alaska, and I went to San Francisco. And some of the teachers there were terrible. Even though San Francisco was like a super nice city, and I really liked it a lot. But
yeah.
The teachers, oh man, that was terrible. Anyways, sorry for the story.
Okay.
How about you?
Did I have a favorite teacher?
Of course.
No.
You didn't? Mm-mm. Really?
Yeah, I mean, I had teachers I liked a lot. Like, my fifth grade teacher was probably one of my favorites, but... I
Come
wasn't
on.
Like,
really?
Yeah.
Because you have weak teachers.
Oh, wait!
Exactly.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
You did, right?
But the fact that I forgot, I mean, must say something.
Yeah, well, it says that you're trying to one up on me.
Well, I had a favorite teacher in high school.
Oh, who was it?
Mrs. Brumba.
I thought so. Brumba, yeah. You said
I just,
that.
I know. Favorite. I was thinking like elementary school and then high school. I just, so Mrs. Brumba.
I thought so.
Okay.
Hold this for just a moment. We'll be right back. I thought so.
Listen. I know. Yeah, it's left. Okay, so yes, you got that right.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
So I was right.
Yes.
Were you right?
No.
You were wrong.
That's wrong.
So you got the answer wrong. Swinging sure. Swan clarity.
Okay. Next Have question. I ever killed a pet before?
Is that really a question?
No. But I'm asking. Jamil, have I ever killed a pet before? Answer.
That would be yes.
Okay.
Multiple.
No. Have I answer?
Here's the question. Have you ever killed an insect before?
No. Have I ever killed a pet?
No.
Okay, and now you. Has Jamil ever killed a pet?
Have I ever intentionally killed a pet before?
I wouldn't say it was unintentional. Yes, he's killed a pet.
I probably shouldn't go into the story.
This is who I'm married to. Okay? No, it was an accident. No, because the story makes me want to cry.
It's sad.
Like, I don't want to know. You don't want to say
it. I'll explain it. Well, you busted it out. Now everyone probably wants to know.
Yeah,
no, it's all good. So pretty much.
Okay, but I just don't want the fam to like judge him.
Oh, it's fine. I don't think anyone's gonna judge me. Look, I was like 10 years old, not thinking at all. Uh-huh. Not thinking at all. Mm-hmm. We had some birds, some parakeets that were in our house.
I feel like we told the story. But
no, I don't think we told it.
Yeah, I don't think we did. Okay, say that.
Also, I hope my family's not listening because they don't know. That's a problem. Let's hope they don't find this video because they don't know at all. They still don't know. I told them the birds fought to the death. That's not what happened. That's not what happened. So pretty much, long story short. Oops, I hit the microphone. Sorry. Long story short is what happened. The bird. My parents would go from time to time, and I always wanted to grab the birds. Parakeets, for the most part, other than the parakeet that we had that was trained, would land on your finger and was really cool, right? But the other ones don't want to come around you, so I had to resort, 10 years old, guys, in trying to grab them. And I tried grabbing them if I could, And one of them, I one day I tried to open it up to try to grab one. He flew out, and I went searching for him, and I couldn't find him anywhere around the house. I was so scared because my parents were coming home any minute. Because
you weren't supposed to open
the cage. Because I was not supposed to open a cage and mess with the birds. So anyways, he flew out. I was looking around the whole house because I couldn't find him. Finally found him, and I grabbed him. And I killed him on accident. I don't need to go into detail.
You didn't mean to.
I really didn't mean to. It's actually a sad story. It's a sad story. And I felt horrible.
Yeah.
I felt really, really bad.
So bad that he lied about it to this day.
Well, I'm not going to tell him now. It's done. It's done. But it was bad. Yeah. I killed him on accident. Okay. And what happened was an accident.
Yeah. Like, you know what? Sure. I know for a fact you're not the first person to accidentally kill your
pet. A lot of people. Well, especially at that age. When you're at that age, mm-hmm. you're a lot rougher. Like, mm-hmm. you don't think...
And if you have a delicate pet, I guess.
Yeah, especially like that. Yeah. Mm-hmm. You don't think, like, be gentle. It's funny, but meanwhile, like, I've played with cats before. Mm-hmm. Like, I haven't had a cat, but, like, very gentle with cats and dogs. But
you're super gentle.
Something with birds. Something about birds. I don't know. I just wanted to grab them. It's weird.
Like, it's all good.
Yeah.
So okay.
It was bad.
Okay.
Okay. Next question.
Okay. Ready?
Yes. Last question.
Sorry.
Are we going to ask the question or not?
Yes, we are. Here we go.
Kristen sent a text message.
Sorry. My sister texted me. Just wanted to start calling back.
Oh, okay.
Okay, here we go.
Yeah. Let's do
this. Oh, now I feel like we know each other on that one. Okay, here we go.
Okay, last one.
Can I change a tire?
Hell no.
Oh my god!
Okay, I'll put it like this. Yes, you can change a tire.
What does that mean?
That means if you were given all the tools, all the time, no one around, theoretically, you had all the time in the world, be anywhere, no AAA. Yeah, you could change a tire. No, here's what I mean.
Do I know
how to change a tire.
Do I know how to change a tire?
Yes. I would say yes, you do.
I think I do too.
How do you change it?
Okay. I got this. Ready? Okay. You find the jack.
A jack? Yes.
You find the car jack.
Car jack, yep.
And then you have to go under the car and you have to put the jack right underneath a place in the car that has like that flat surface thing. Mm-hmm. You know, just put it anywhere.
Yep.
And then you pump up the jack.
Okay.
Depending on, you know, pump up the jack to get the certain, wherever tire, you know, you have to pump it up nearby the tire that you need to change. Mm-hmm. Then, you take that weird thing.
The weird thing.
And you gotta take off the bolts.
Tire iron.
And you basically gotta take off all the bolts, and that's hella hard.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you take off the bolts, take the tire off.
Yeah, it's super
easy. Put the spare tire on, put it back on the bolts. Yeah. Right?
What about the spare tire? You didn't pull a spare tire off?
Oh, yeah, you gotta find a spare tire back.
Yeah, you know what to do. It's actually relatively easy.
Let's be real, both of us have never changed a tire.
I have.
Let's not lie.
No, I've changed a tire. Oh, no. Okay, so I know how to change a tire. I've been with people that have changed the tires before, and I helped out. But there was one time in particular, we were going to change the tire, but when I put the jack under, I put the jack in possibly the wrong place. Mm-hmm. I put it underneath the it was pretty much in the right place, but I think
his you told me about
thing
this.
Was weak.
You told me
and
about
I tried
this.
To lift it, and it was like breaking the plastic underneath. So it was his fault.
He put it in the wrong place.
I think so.
Funny.
Oh, I did. So in work, in shop. Mm-hmm. I changed the tire.
I know you're going to bring up shop.
I did.
Yes.
I did. We changed it in shop. I forgot about that. Everyone had a change. Did I tell you about that?
Yeah, you did.
So there you have it. So I changed a car before, but it was already lifted, was the difference. So that's the only difference. I've changed it before, though.
Okay. One more question.
Okay, one more.
You have changed it. That's true.
Yeah.
Okay.
One more. Let's get a good one.
Okay.
Let's get a good one.
Okay.
All right. Do you need a minute?
No.
Here you sure?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, God, you know all these.
Exactly.
Every food-related question, we hella know.
I know.
Okay, here we go.
Okay.
What's my favorite part of my body?
What What's your favorite part of your body? Have you mentioned this before?
I don't know.
Exactly.
I have a couple.
I think Chris is making this up.
I have a couple that are number one, so if you get any of them.
A couple.
I do.
I would say your hair.
Oh, no, but that is a good one. That should be up there.
Exactly.
Okay. I'll give that to you.
Exactly.
I'll give it to you.
Exactly.
But it's not, you know, it's probably number two.
Okay, I was going to say smile.
Yeah. I do like my smile.
Exactly. So I got two.
Okay.
I got two.
Okay, ready?
Okay, let's hear
for
it.
For you?
It's not
you like don't even have this. A favorite
I know, part. But let me think about it. Okay. So there's no way you would know this.
Why would I not know? Oh, because, yeah.
Okay. Favorite part of my body?
Your arms?
Nope.
Your dimple?
Nope.
Your smile?
Nope.
Your butt?
Kristen doesn't know me.
You don't have a favorite part, then.
You know this. We've talked somewhat about this.
Your chest?
This is terrible. No, come on. This is making me a little sad.
Calm down.
Yeah. You don't know?
Your legs?
Can I just tell you?
Yeah.
It's my elbows.
Okay.
My elbows. Kristen, we've talked about this. You guys,
it
my
is a
elbows
pretty elbow.
Are unlike anyone else's.
You
got it right. My arms.
Hey! My arms are good. Yeah. I would say we were
and
pretty
smile.
Tired. We should have kept track.
But... Yeah. No, I won.
What?
Brumba, your teacher?
Brumba.
Brumba, your teacher?
Brumba. That's like the dance?
No, that's not the dance. The Roomba?
The Roomba's a dance.
Is that a dance?
Yes.
It's also the thing that
which
vacuums.
Which I would kill if I knew how to do it. No, you I would love to Roomba.
If you knew how to do it. Listen, I would kill at anything if I knew how to do it. Okay? I'd be the best.
No, Roombas is like...
The Roomba. What are you doing? That, what is that? Is that a dance?
It's the Roomba. It's very like... You know...
I don't know what you're talking about. What is it? Oh, I've never heard of that. That's hilarious.
It's very
aggressive?
Hippie.
I see
hippie.
What you're saying.
And, you know, you do the hips a lot.
Got it.
It's very sensual. am I turning on when I do this?
No, I don't even know what you're doing. I don't know. Like, it's really hot.
Can I tell a story super quick? Okay, before we go.
Yeah, but let me say what the Roomba is. The Roomba's the vacuum cleaner thing. The thing that goes around your room that's a robot. Circular.
Oh.
And it just goes. You just
Roombot.
Let it...
Isn't that like a Roombot?
Oh, no. I think it's a Roomba.
Swear.
I'm probably wrong.
Man.
Okay,
okay, really
quick.
I think
it is a Roombot.
Okay. I thought it was.
I could be wrong. I thought it was a Roomba.
Oh, it is a Roomba. Mm-hmm. Okay.
I thought so.
Okay.
I was at Linens and Things when those things came out. I remember it was like a big topic of the day. They were like, it vacuums by itself. We're like, no. I'm serious. I can't do that. We had a little container in the store where people would just let it go. And we would just like watch it all day.
That's funny.
Okay, let's hear your story.
Okay, so super quick. So yesterday I was telling Jamil I was doing like some type of a ballroom dance in front of him. I was going like this. I was doing something amazing in front of him. And I was like, I could have been a professional dancer.
Yeah.
And he goes, not like that.
Which is so true.
Not doing that.
Which is so true.
Oh, that was so mean.
Well, you should have seen the guys. You would have felt the same. Like,
they just saw it.
Like
I was
that.
Doing some type of a...
No, it wasn't even that.
Like, not like that. Oh, so
which
funny.
Is true.
Okay.
Okay, you guys, we're wrapping this up. We hope you enjoyed the food so and the questions.
Yes.
I'm going to say just ultimately, I'm going to be honest. I'm just not a big fan of the wingman wings. Earlier in the week, we actually had a sandwich from them, pork sandwich, and the fries were really good. But the wings, they're good. They're good. The barbecue taste is better than the other wings.
Mm-hmm.
To me, the wine wings. But I think just ultimately, the wings are smaller. I think the Wingstop wings are juicier, too.
Two things. So. One, rewind to the beginning of this video where he was saying that he enjoyed the wingman more than...
Did I say that?
I feel like
no,
you did.
No, the barbecue.
Okay.
I said the barbecue is better.
That you enjoy
flavor.
Better.
Yeah,
okay.
The flavor's better.
Okay.
But after eating everything and having and kind of assessing now, okay. What I'm saying is
I mean,
the flavor was
in.
Better. Yeah, the flavor was better. And I think the flavor was better even if they had more sauce on the Hawaiian wings, mm-hmm. Wingstop ones. But I just think I think you're right about the juiciness of it and just a few other things. Mm-hmm. Just not,
I am not right. for me. Okay, cool. And then number two, the second thing I was going to say is I love how serious he gets when he does these videos. Yes,
because this is a serious topic.
I do think Wingstop One, we do agree on that. So.
Absolutely. Yay! Yeah, for
but
sure.
But this place is good. It's just, I like the juiciness, the flavors, I think, better.
It would be, to me, I think, it would be probably a 4-star for me. 4-star for sure.
The Roomba. Okay. It's my face.
Yes, and emotions, too. Those are,
it's like they do, these things, you know? Okay, anyways.
All right, guys.
Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe, and share. Sharing is caring. Let your friends and family know what the K&J fam are doing. Get us up to 5,000 subs on YouTube, please.
We're almost there.
And join us on Facebook on Sunday for a giveaway. We're super excited. We can't wait to see you guys.
We hope you guys can make it. And if you have any questions, feel free to comment below. We'll answer them regarding the contest. But other than that, guys, we hope you have... you said it already.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
Wonderful
day, evening, or night, whatever time it is out there for you. We look forward to seeing you next time because I can't remember what we were going to say because I just threw myself off.
Peace out, Chad.